Hey guys, Raider here. Hope you're all doing great and having a fantastic day. Check this out real quick, guys. So we're on the Galaxy Book 2 Pro 360. Just messing around with File Explorer. Head over here to the tab S8 Ultra. Let's go to our recent apps. Let's open up this Word document. Just typing. We'll head over to the Galaxy Book 2 Pro 360. Let's grab a log file here. Transfer it over. All right, guys, what we're looking at is Samsung's brand new feature called Multi-Control. This is available on the Galaxy Book 2 Pro 360 along with the other Galaxy Book 2 lineup, and it should soon trickle down to last year's model as well, and it's designed to be used with Samsung's Galaxy tablets, and this is coming out on the Tab S8 line, the Tab S7 line, and this allows us to use our keyboard and mouse from our laptop and carry it over to our tablet. So basically like a built-in KVM switch with the ability to do file copies as well. So guys, in this video, I'm going to walk you through all the steps of getting this set up on your Galaxy Book 2 laptop, as well as your Tab S8 or other tablet that you may have. We'll go over all the prerequisites, and then I'm going to do a full demo of all the functionality that this has. Before we get started, I want to thank one of my viewers, Joe. Thank you so much for all our interactions and for all your input on Multi-Control. We've been having a lot of back and forth talks. Very grateful for all your help, Joe, and thank you so much for helping a lot of people down in the comments section as well. So the first thing into getting this set up is we need to configure each device. Let's start with the simpler one first. So I'm going to bring in the Tab S8 Ultra. We'll move this out of the way for now. Okay, the first thing, guys, is you want to make sure that you have this latest update installed. I'm going to show it on the screen here. This update is what brings the Multi-Control functionality to the Galaxy tablets. And once it's done, there's just a couple other things that you need to do. So you need to make sure you have Bluetooth enabled. You don't need to be paired to anything. You just need to make sure that it's enabled. In addition to that, you need to make sure that your Galaxy tablet is on the same Wi-Fi network that you're going to be using your Samsung laptop with. Once you have those settings configured, you can validate that Multi-Control is all set up by going into your settings, scrolling down on the left here, till we get to advanced features. And you're gonna see we have a new option here for Multi-Control. So we go ahead and click on that, and we have it on, and there's nothing else you have to do on your Galaxy tablet. All right, so now on your Galaxy Book 2 Pro, or whatever one you have of the Galaxy Book 2 laptops, the most important thing that you need right off the bat is a Samsung Continuity Service. You can validate whether or not you already have it installed by doing this. Open up Start, type Samsung Update, go ahead and click on that. What we're interested in is a Samsung Apps. And if you don't have it installed, it's gonna show up here in the available apps, just like it looks like we've got an update for studio mode. Wow, they're just coming out with tons of them, my goodness. But what we're looking for should be all the way towards the bottom, and there it is, Samsung Continuity Service. This is required for the Multi-Control. Once that's set up, you also need to make sure you have Bluetooth on. So you go ahead and click Bluetooth and other devices, all right? Bluetooth is on. You don't need to pair it anything. It's gonna handle all that on its own. Just make sure it's on. And the other thing you need to make sure is that you're on the same Wi-Fi network. Once you're sure that you have Bluetooth enabled on both devices and that they're both on the same Wi-Fi network, you wanna go ahead to your Start menu. You wanna open up Samsung Settings. All right, go to Advanced Features. And we see we have a new Multi-Control function. So you wanna turn this on. And you'll see here, it's not working. So it says here that we need to be on the same Bluetooth and same Wi-Fi network. Well, let me show you guys something. What I discovered in the early goings of using this is that I had to make a tweak to my wireless settings. Just type in network adapters. Then you'll click on view network connections. So once you have your wireless network adapters open, you go ahead and right click on your Wi-Fi one, click properties. All right, go ahead and click on configure. Go to advanced. And you're gonna have wireless mode. So for me, mine was on the default option of 5, and I just switched it around for this demonstration. What you want to do is make sure that you're picking the same band that your tablet's on. So if I go up to this 5 gigahertz option right here, I go ahead and click OK. Give it just a second. Galaxy Book 2 linked to Brian's Tab S8 Ultra. You'll see now we have two screens available, the tablet and the PC, and the tablet's over to the right. So if you face any issues with it just sitting here spinning on you, go ahead and just change your wireless network adapter settings. You'll still be connected to the internet and all that. There's a few of them to play around with. One of them, the first one you have doesn't work, just switch it. All of a sudden it'll work. And the cool thing is you can just now leave this on both devices. All right, guys, so this is how you set up Multi-Control on both of them. Now what I wanna do is do a complete walkthrough with you guys. So let's go ahead and get started with that. All right, so let's talk about the different orientations and positions you can set this up in. You'll see here on the left that we have PC on the left and tablet as the right option here. And this is just like setting up multiple displays on your Windows PC, right? So the tablet display is gonna be over here. So we scroll over here and you see that the cursor went over to the tablet. It's now back. We can take the tablet and move it over to here. Click apply. And now when I go over to this side, it's now gonna come over to the tablet over here. So this is designed for you to have the tablet over on the left-hand side. But there's a couple other things you can do that's cool too. Here's what I like to do. This is my favorite setting, is take the tablet and put it up diagonal to the PC, just like that. Click apply. And what's great about this is that if you leave the multi-control function on, let's say you just have your Tab S8 or your whatever Galaxy tablet you have, it's over to the side or something. You're watching movies, this and that. You don't always want to use multi-control. You'll see now the cursor is completely stuck within the laptop itself. And the way that we get over to the Tab S8 Ultra now is we go right up into the corner. Now watch what happens here on the tablet. Bam, and it squeezes right up into the corner of the tablet. This way you're very rarely accidentally going to ever go over to your Galaxy tablet. And when you do want to go back and forth between them, you have this little narrow section that'll get you between both devices. So another thing you can do that's really cool is if you have a tablet stand or some type of holder where you can put the tablet right on top of your laptop, you know, so you're just looking above instead of sideways all the time. Or if you want to use other screens to extend your Windows desktop and then have your tablet experience up here up top, is you can take the tablet, move it right to the top of the PC, click apply, and now we can go right up to the tablet, right? Go to our apps, open up our app drawer, head right back down to the Galaxy Book 2. I think that's pretty cool, you know, being able to go up and down between them. You could also put the tablet underneath, whatever position you want. And this is really great for just separating your tablet from all your Windows work. So I know what you guys are wondering, does it work with DeX? All right, we've got DeX loaded up. And there you go, works just fine. Here we are with our apps, app drawer, everything you want. DeX works totally good. We'll go ahead and exit. When you're using one of these, you can plug in a keyboard and mouse and just control the whole kit and caboodle with your keyboard and mouse. Put your laptop over here, put your Tab S8 over here, and you basically have a full KVM switch type situation going on. So guys, are there any drawbacks? Are there any negatives? Well, yeah, so there is. So I've noticed a few quirks already. And again, this is as of the timing of the making of this video. I mean, things are likely gonna change here as updates come out and stuff. So when you're over here on the Tab S8 Ultra screen with the cursor, you're not gonna be able to pull down the settings and you're not gonna be able to push up with two fingers to open up the app drawer. You can scroll left and right like this with two fingers. It accepts two finger input going left to right. But for some reason, at the time of the making of this video, the up and down feature is just not working. I mean, I've played around with this like all day, guys, and it's just not happening. But there's some workarounds to all this. Let me show you something. So you can get to your settings real quick. Put your mouse pointer all the way to the top of the screen, and you just click one time. It'll pull down your settings and notification panel. Then you can start moving around with it from here. Now you'll also notice on the bottom here that I have the navigation bar set up. That's because it's needed as well. So, and the reason being is if you don't have this, you're not gonna be able to go to your recent apps, you won't be able to get to home, and you're not gonna be able to go to back because you don't have those gestures available. So I do recommend showing your nav bar icons for this situation. Let me go ahead and show you how to enable that and also how to enable the app icon drawer since we don't have a quick way to, you know, get to our apps. So you're gonna go to settings, wanna go to display, gonna scroll all the way down till we get to navigation bar. And you have buttons and swipe gestures. I typically always use swipe gestures. That way it doesn't leave the buttons on the bottom of the screen and we don't have to worry about OLED burn-in because those are persistent. But for this situation, we do need to enable them. So you're gonna go ahead and turn on buttons. And here's what I recommend, guys. Like maybe once a week or so, you might wanna come in here and just adjust the button order or adjust the button position from like center, left to right. That way these buttons are being moved around and that kind of lowers your risk of any type of OLED burn-in. And as I mentioned earlier, we don't have a quick way to get to our app drawer. Look at, I'm going up like this with two fingers. It's just not working. We can't get to the app drawer unless we swipe up with our fingers. So the workaround to that is to go to settings, go to home screen, And on home screen, you're going to have an option for show app screen button on home screen. Go ahead and enable that. And what that's going to do is show this little thing right here. That's your app icon drawer. So now you'll be able to go over from your Galaxy Book 2 Pro or Galaxy Book 2 Pro 360 and just click on that to get to your app drawer. Cool thing about having this set up too, guys, is now you don't really need your book cover keyboard with your Tab S8 Ultra unless you take it on the go. I think that's pretty awesome. And I believe I briefly touched on this in the introduction, but you also have this feature as well to where you can just drag and copy over files. You'll get a transferring complete. And where that's going to be is if you go into your app drawer, you're going to go to My Files, and you go over to your Downloads. All right, there we have Overwatch Log, and that's what we have here. I've already copied it over twice. You can do videos, pictures, large files, small files, whatever you want. It'll copy it back and forth between your devices. All right, guys, well, I think it's a pretty cool feature. You know, now we have like this remote control feature. It kind of reminds me of Apple's Universal Control. Every once in a while, it feels just a little bit laggy, but not really once you get using it. It's just kind of when you switch over from the Galaxy Book over to it. You know, sometimes there's just a little bit of like that quirkiness, but it only lasts for like a small fraction of a second. Everything's good to go from there. Keyboard input works great. I think this is some pretty awesome functionality that we're going to see further enhanced with future updates. All right, guys, if you have any questions about this at all or you run into any troubles in getting it set up, please drop a comment down in the comment section. And do keep in mind, like, the main thing that held me back was having the update for the Tab S8 Ultra. That update came yesterday. I was kind of dead in the water until that showed up. So do make sure you have both devices completely updated, and you should be in pretty good shape. All right, guys, as always, thanks for watching.